Hey guys, Luther here from YakAttack. Welcome to another edition of Rigging the Dream. What we're gonna do today, we're gonna install the LeverLoc anchor trolley, the standard anchor trolley on this CUDA 14. So we're gonna go through how to place all the components, how to install all the components, how to make sure you get an install that looks good and functions great. Okay, so today we're gonna be working with the LeverLoc anchor trolley kit, the standard kit. It's the AMS1003. Let's take a look at what we've got inside the package here. So the first thing you're going to notice for hardware, we've got self-threading screws. That's all we need to do this install. Getting into the package. Got a set of instructions. We've got two Harkin pulleys. We've got the LeverLoc clamp base and the LeverLoc lever. The ring. Two pad hooks, and made in the USA reflective paracord. So that's what we're gonna be working with here. Let's see how to get these guys on the boat. Okay, so the first thing we wanna do before we get started drilling any holes, we wanna see kind of where we want everything placed. It's really good to think about this a little bit ahead of time. Looking at this boat, we've got a little bit of rigging up here in the front. We don't want our lines to be getting tangled up in that. So we're gonna put our forward pulley about as far forward as we can get it, just below the chine. That's gonna get the lines down out of the way of the deck rigging. Coming on back to the LeverLoc, the position here that seems to be the best is actually just above the chine so that it's within reach and so we're not getting down too close to the water line. And then on the rear of the boat, the pulley here, once again, just below the chine, clear of the rudder cables, and it's gonna give us a nice flow throughout the boat. What this means is that somewhere we're gonna be crossing the chine in the front half of the boat, also in the back half of the boat. That's what we're gonna use our pad hooks for. They're gonna guide the line so that we get a nice, straight, clean install that's not tangled up and that looks good. One thing we wanna do is we wanna go ahead and kinda hold our LeverLoc base in place and go ahead and put the ring in just to make sure that thing's gonna stow the way we want it to. This boat has a pretty close to vertical side gunnel. That's good. If it was at a really steep angle, we've seen some boats where the ring just kind of sticks out. So before we drill any holes, the big thing is we want to make sure everything's going to look the way that we want it to look. This looks great, so we can get started. Okay, so here we are ready to install the pulley on the bow of the boat. We've got the pulley and we've got two of the longer screws. Nice thing about this install is all we're going to have to do is drill an 1/8-inch hole, thread these directly into the boat. So we're gonna take the 1/8-inch drill bit, position the pulley. I'm just gonna kinda use the pulley as a guide here and get that first hole. Once I do that, before drilling that next hole, I'd like to go ahead and start this screw. That way the pulley doesn't shift around on me and cause the holes to be misaligned. This first screw will just kinda hold it in place. Make sure it's nice and straight, and then drill that second hole. And put that screw in, and just like that, the forward pulley is done. So let's move to the rear of the boat. Okay, so now we've got the rear pulley. Again, two of the longer screws. Gonna just kinda line this thing up. Put that first screw in. You have to push a little bit to get these screws started. We actually drilled this hole. It's a little bit smaller than the shank of the screw because we wanted to create a watertight connection. And because of that, it does take a little bit of pressure to get them started. And then you don't want to over tighten them. You want to get them nice and snug, but we don't want to strip the plastic out. And drill that second hole. Put the second screw in. Again, careful not to over tighten, but we want to make sure it's snug. Now we can put our rope in place, the trolley line in place, kind of get an idea for how that's going to lay on the boat so that we can get all the rest of the components installed in a way that looks good and is free of any kind of tangles or anything like that. Okay, so I've untangled the trolley line, got it laid out, and we're gonna go ahead and just kind of hang it in place on the boat so we can get a feel for how the line's gonna route down the side of the boat so we can get all of our other components positioned correctly. We're gonna wanna go through the bottom of the pulley and out the top. That way when we go through the other pulley, that'll create our continuous loop on the top side of the pulley, which is what we need for it to line up correctly in the LeverLoc base. So we're gonna go from the bottom and then in through the top of this one. So our continuous part of our loop again is on top. We're gonna grab the two ends of the rope here. Just gonna do a little loop on one end and then put the line through it. And all I wanna do is get enough tension here to kinda see how this thing's gonna hang on the boat. This isn't a permanent loop by any stretch, but it's gonna give us enough of an idea of how the line wants to naturally route that we can position our components. It's gonna give us a nice smooth transition through all of the different guides. That looks pretty good. Okay, so here I've got the LeverLoc base. I went ahead and pressed the little lever onto it. I've got it in the unlocked position. And I've got two of the shorter screws that came with the kit. And just like with the pulleys, what we're gonna do here, first off, the groove where the clamp is, that's where your line's gonna go. And then we're just gonna position this thing in place where we want it and drill another 1/8 inch hole. We're going to go ahead and screw that in. Make sure our line is guided through here correctly and snug it up. Get it nice and straight, and then we'll drill our second hole and put in the second screw. Just gonna snug both of these up, make sure they're tight, but we don't wanna over tighten them and strip out the plastic. So now we can see, we've got the LeverLoc installed, it's clamping the line, now we can put our pad hooks in. Okay, so the goal for the pad hook is really just to guide the line. We've got the little half moon shape here, which is gonna hold the rear loop or the inner loop. And then we've got the other side, which is a hook, so that if the line wants to try to come up on the gunwale, it'll just keep that from happening. So we're just gonna find what we think is the best place here, nice flat spot that's gonna guide that line about like we want it. And then drill a hole. Again, using the shorter screws, go ahead and put that first screw in. Get it nice and straight, drill the second hole. Put that screw in. We'll move on to the front. Here we are on the front of the boat. Again, we're just gonna see kinda where's the best place to guide this line to keep it nice and straight. Put the pad hook in place, drill that first hole. One thing you'll notice, this boat's got a little bit of curvature to it. When we tighten it down, this pad hook is kind of sitting flat here, not so flat here. That's okay though, because this is made from a really flexible plastic, so we can actually just push that down flat before we drill the hole, and it'll contour right to the boat. so that's all the drilling, that's all the line guiding. Now it's just a matter of connecting the ring. Okay, so now we're gonna connect the ring. You've got a couple of different options here. Sometimes people will wanna put a bungee through one side to give a little bit of stretch. We're not gonna worry about that. We're just gonna do a direct attachment. We're just gonna pull the loose end here, put it through the back of the ring on one of the holes in a small overhand knot. We're gonna snug that up a little bit, and it's gonna be big enough that it won't pull back through the ring. So that gives you a good connection there. Then on the other side, we'll just take out the knot that we put in earlier and do the same thing. Now, one thing to remember is that once this line gets wet and dries out a couple of times, it's actually gonna tighten up. It's actually gonna shrink a little bit. So we don't wanna over tighten at this point, but we want it to be fairly snug. So I'm just gonna get, you know, kind of a, you know, loose but fairly snug amount of tension, mark my line, and then go ahead and get it to where I can put an overhand knot. And what I suggest here, go ahead and take it out, check it. You can see that's a little bit too loose. We can just move the knot until we get it like we want it. And that's gonna hang pretty good on the boat. It's gonna give us some room that this thing can shrink a little bit. It's gonna stow well. And then when I cut this line, instead of cutting it right at the knot, I'm gonna give myself a little bit of room here, especially through the first couple of wet dry cycles. I'm just gonna leave a little bit extra, so if later on I wanna loosen this thing up, I can. And just take a lighter, be real careful here not to get hot plastic stuck to you, but just kinda burn the end. Keep that from fraying. And that's it. Okay, so there you have it. That's a standard anchor trolley install. Keep in mind later on, if you wanna add backing plates, you feel like you're gonna be doing some more heavy duty stuff, or you just wish you had done it, even if you didn't get the HD kit, you can always go back and get the backing plate kit. For instructions on how to do that, you can check this channel. We've got another video showing how to do the backing plate install, whether it's a new installation or how to add backing plates to your old installation. Make sure you check that out. And also, if you've got any questions about this install, if you have any content you'd like to see on this channel, please make mention of that in the comments below. We'll definitely keep an eye on that. And make sure you subscribe to this channel. This is where we're gonna be putting all of the different product information, install information. So make sure you do that, and we'll keep rigging the dream.